In order to properly prepare for an audit, I would say that a company needs to be closing their books either monthly or quarterly. And closing the books can mean a lot of things. Many clients have different audit areas, is what I call them, like cash, AR, which stands for accounts receivable, AP, which stands for accounts payable, fixed assets, prepaids, investments, long-term payables for loans that they have, and short-term payables like vendors that they owe. All of these accounts need to be reconciled on a monthly basis, and also some of those accounts need to be reviewed in detail to see if there's any point or any old receivables or payables that need to be dealt with. Sometimes what you find when you're closing the books is a fraudulent entry that your auditor would need to know about. Another thing when you're closing the books, you want to do a review of payroll. And generally speaking, payroll is happening bi-weekly or monthly. And you want to do a review to make sure the people on your payroll are actually the people that work for your company. And this test is something a lot of people don't do, but would be helpful to identify fraud early. Any significant transactions that happen during the year, those transactions, you should contact your auditor as you're closing the books to see how to properly make those entries, because an auditor doesn't like to be surprised. So even if you know how to handle the entry, if it's significant in value or in a change that you've done as an operational change, you need to contact your auditor and let them know. One thing that helps with closing the books is if you have an accounting policy will help your employees understand what to do at the end of every month. Now, this will be more in detail also about who opens the mail, who that mail goes to, who enters the mail into the accounting system, all of those types of things with regards to invoice payment. That's just one of the examples of what would be in this handbook. This handbook would cover a multitude of control areas. And if you have that handbook, you give that to your auditor will be very happy because they will know how to test your controls. Also, it'll let them know that you have made accounting a priority and that you have prioritized the accounting rules that your company is going to go by. Sometimes what clients will forget is that auditors are actually going to be coming out to your place of business. So it's really good to have a place for them. Make sure you have your Wi-Fi ready because many auditors are going paperless these days and they're also wanting to connect back to their server. So having a place where they have adequate internet is very important. Having a place for them to sit is also very important because there's numerous times we will be looking at sensitive information. So you want to make sure that not only they have space, but it's not somewhere open where everyone's going to come because they may see sensitive data that they're not supposed to. So I would suggest to find an office that can house however many people are coming out. One of the reasons you want to be in communication with your auditor early is to find out exactly how many people are coming. If you know how many people are coming, you can set aside the right amount of space for those people. As an auditor, before I come out, I will actually do a risk assessment on the company that I'm auditing. So it's important to know what happened during the year so that I make an appropriate risk assessment. And anything that I find that's surprising to me, that you didn't contact me because it was a significant transaction, or you had some new line of business that you opened that I was not expecting. Expectation is what an auditor lives on because we plan everything based on our expectations. If anything doesn't meet that expectation, we're going to have a question. The best thing to do is to contact your auditor when those things happen because they're going to want to know. And that way they don't have to adjust their risk while they're on the spot. Lastly, I'd like to say that auditors are not the enemy. One of the things that we come across sometimes is that there's this adversarial relationship because clients think that we are looking for problems. While we are looking for problems, we're not looking for problems for their sake. We're actually looking for it to help you. We were hired by you, we're doing a job for you, and we want you to have a pleasant experience. So as we're going through and we do find the problems, we want to help you solve those problems so that you are successful in the future.